All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sport Chat 503. Thank you guys very much for watching. First time, long time. Either way, I appreciate it. Coming to you live from Portland, Oregon, trying to break out everything down here on the West Coast. We have some pretty exciting stuff happening. I got Oregon videos. I got Pac-12 videos, National College Football videos, Top 10 videos once we get to the BCS, all that good stuff on Tuesdays. And this is the National College Football Perspective, looking at kind of what happened last week, looking at what's going on this next week. This is basically the Top 10. Here we go. We had a huge week for LSU. LSU does look like the number one team in the nation. Ohio State looks like the number two or number one, vice versa. I'm okay if you want to flip those. But those two teams look like by far the best teams. LSU takes Ole Miss behind the woodshed, 58-37, and then obviously Ohio State was going to beat Rutgers. I'm just happy Rutgers scored some points in general. But LSU puts themselves up in a pretty good situation for next week. Have a big week against Arkansas, and then you got Texas A&M, then you got the SEC Championship. The LSU situation this last week, they went from, you know, their pass defense is now up, their pass offense is now up to number two in the nation. And their rushing, defense is the 33rd best rush defense. Their defense overall is 47th. Not great, but they're outscoring people. And Joe Burrow's got such a great situation going on there with his passing that you don't really need to stop that many people, especially the way that they're scoring the ball. So they're averaging, you know, probably 30-something points a game, 30-plus points a game. The only game they haven't really scored 40 points is the Bama or the Auburn game, and that was a fairly close game. In the Bama game, they sort of scored 46. So it's pretty awesome for LSU. Ohio State comes in. Their offense, number four in the country. Their defense, number one in the country. They have the best pass defense in the country, and they have the fourth best rushing offense in the country. So really solid team. Really, really, really solid across the bottom. They got Penn State. It's a big game for them. They got at Michigan. The at Michigan game is looking better, but this Penn State game is going to be the one. If Ohio State wants to really flex on the nation, they'll come out and crush Penn State, which I'm assuming they will do. Penn State has not impressed me that much lately, especially, and Ohio State is definitely impressing me. So I feel like Ohio State has the absolute green light, ready to go, and they'll hammer time. Big Ten Championship as well, I don't see anybody getting in their way on that one. So it feels like to me they're an automatic. LSU and Ohio State feels like is a game planner all the way down. LSU may be a question mark with the SEC Championship, but Ohio State looks like it's in. And at the end of the day, maybe Ohio State does flip and become the number one team over LSU at the end. You never know what could happen there, right? Clemson, third team in the country, obviously crushing people after that UNC hiccup where they almost lost there. If Mac Brown could have converted that, if they could have converted that two-point conversion, we could have been in a different situation. But after that failed two-point conversion, basically, Clemson's just been peeling teams off one after the other. They do the same thing to Wake, 52-3, just absolute crushing. At South Carolina looked like a tough game after that Georgia game, but South Carolina since then has not looked good, and not surprising to see Clemson just rattle off the rest of these wins and might put themselves in a situation where they are right where they're at right now, the third-place team in, and with no questions. Now we get an interesting part, right, with the fourth team. Right now we're sitting at Georgia and Bama in that 4-5 spot. Georgia flips Bama this week with the Tua injury, a brutal injury. Super, super, super sad to see a guy like that. Such a great player. I heard people talking about how he might be one of the top three, four best players at Bama's history, maybe the number one player in Bama's history. Pretty crazy deal there. I feel really bad for the kid, and I feel bad for Alabama fans, but I don't think you should punish Bama just because they lost their quarterback too much. I mean, I obviously, as a Duck fan, I saw the Cordell Jones third-string quarterback come off the bench and win a national championship for Ohio State, so crazier things have happened, but I understand where they're going with that. Georgia moves up, but I don't like Georgia's loss either. I mean, it was a close one. I get it, two overtimes, but, you know, if you're comparing those losses, you know, obviously you have some wins there, but if you're comparing those losses, you know, obviously Alabama's loss is the best, even though they got crushed with the scoreboard. They let up way more points than they probably are used to with 46 points. They made it interesting and came up close at the end and only lost by 5. Georgia offensively is 47th in the country. Defensively, they're 6th in the country. Clemson is 3rd in offense and defense, they're 2nd. So you look at Ohio State and Clemson, they're both the highest ranked teams in both those categories. Clemson's the 2nd best pass defense in the country and the 10th best rushing offense in the country. Georgia rushes the ball fairly well, 24th best in the country, but their defense, Georgia's defense of the rush game, is the 3rd best in the country. So these teams all find themselves right there in those national rankings, and it's pretty interesting to see that stuff. Alabama has slipped. Alabama went to 8th offensively. They're the 3rd best passing offense in the country, and that's obviously strange to see comparatively to where you've seen in the past with the running game for Alabama. And then defensively, they're 27th in the country, which is not great for Alabama, which is kind of explaining where they're at right now. And that's the 19th best pass defense. I think that's kind of an interesting one to look at it. You know, West Carolina is not going to really give them anything. They blow out Mississippi State, and they lose a couple different people in that injury as well, not just Tua in that game. Auburn game is going to be interesting. It's going to be real interesting. I don't know if Auburn can beat Alabama, but if Auburn beats Alabama, this could be a wild ending to the SEC. Oregon's after Alabama and Georgia. The Alabama and Georgia is those two SEC one-loss teams, and then you have the two Pac-12 one-loss teams. Oregon is the 22nd best offense in the country, 31st best passing offense. You would assume that'd be better with Justin Herbert, but they do run the ball quite a bit. Defensively, they're the 14th best defense in the country. That is surprising, especially where Oregon has been historically, as one of the worst defenses in the country just 2 or 3 years ago. And that's the 11th best rush defense. So they do a fairly good job stopping the run. You know, top 15-ish. They're going to end the season with some games that are really not going to strengthen their schedule until they get to the Pac-12 championship. When Oregon gets the Pac-12 championship, hopefully against Utah, that will be a quality win that might be better than Oklahoma or anybody else. Penn State, if Penn State keeps rolling, or Alabama, or even Georgia, maybe. The Florida win, obviously, is a great one, but Utah is pinning themselves up there really, really, really close to Oregon in the top 10, and that top 10 win at the end of the year might be weighted more than Georgia and Florida's win earlier in the year. Oklahoma sits at themselves, let's go to Utah. Utah finds themselves at 25th in the country offensively. They're the 3rd best defense in the country, and that's the number one rush defense in the country. Again, a very important thing to understand, especially in that Pac-12 championship when Oregon, a major rushing team, is going up against Utah, a team that stops the run better than anybody in the country. That's a great matchup. Utah is going to end the year off with wins as well. Colorado's not going to stop them. Arizona's not going to stop them. So they should be right there in the saddle, ready to go for the Pac-12 championship as well. Oklahoma with a huge win over Baylor, an absolutely massive comeback. We really didn't understand what was going to happen here with Baylor. It looked like the committee was not respecting them with that placement of where they were at outside the top 10, being undefeated. They do get tested. They come up ready for the test. The first half, they're cruising. They're just killing it in the first quarter. And then here comes Oklahoma all the way back, and Oklahoma gets the win. This is a massive win. It really does a lot to change the dynamic of the college football playoffs, though, because this is a situation where Oklahoma now is going to have a Big 12 championship game. And if Oklahoma can beat TCU and beat Oklahoma State end of the year, they're going to probably face Baylor again for the Big 12 championship. And again, I don't see where Baylor is going to be in that top 25 ranking anywhere near what Utah is going to be. And you start comparing who has the better win. Obviously, Iowa State is a big win. Texas is a big win. The Baylor win is their biggest win of the year for Oklahoma. But I don't really see exactly, when you start comparing the losses, that KSU loss looks way worse than Oregon's Auburn loss. And so I just don't see the Big 12 getting in. This was kind of a situation, this Oklahoma over Baylor. You know, at this point in the game, I think the Big 12 needed Baylor to win out to be even in the conversation of the college football playoffs. So that's crazy to me. But it is what it is. Penn State comes in at the end there. The 50th best offense in the country, the 46th best pass offense, and then 17th in the country defensively. That's the fourth best rushing defense. Yeah, they've got Ohio State at Ohio State, then they got Rutgers to end the year. If Penn State can beat Ohio State, then they're right in this conversation, obviously. If Penn State really struggles against Ohio State, then they're gone, and they're heading to the Outback Bowl or wherever other bowl they can go with those two losses. But the Minnesota loss is such a crazy one to them, because then Minnesota turns around and loses right away the next week. So if Minnesota keep winning, maybe that loss looks better to Penn State. All right, guys, thank you guys for watching Sports Chat.